Hello everybody, my name is Tucker, and welcome back to our Russian Fishing 4 Float Fishing character. I had so much fun the last time I was here that I decided to come back to the same spot here at Quarry. Seeing the nibble right now, I can't quite see what's on there, it's just deep enough. I did take a quick look at the records before I got started. We did get bumped off the Global Weekly, as I kind of expected would be the case. However, we do have all five U.S. telescopic weekly records for Quarry Whitefish. I am considering throwing out a second telescopic rod for Quarry Whitefish. We'll see. This is probably a roach because of how long it's nibbling. Didn't miss a fish over here while I was watching it. That was a Vindus. I am going to go ahead and throw out my other walrus stick. Thought about doing this beforehand, but decided against it while still debating it in my head. The difference between these two, those who haven't been watching long, because I haven't used the second one, this one has monofilament line. This one has fluorocarbon line on it. I also have a size 6 hook on the fluorocarbon line rod, size 4 on the mono. I did not look at Vindices for weekly records. We'll have to do that here in a little bit. Small Vindus there. Didn't stay hooked. It did. That's why I switched. No, I didn't say anything. I switched between rods there so I could try and hook them both. Did get both of them. 107, I think. Yeah, 107 and 201. 204, sorry. Two decent Vinduses. Two decent Vindis. Did put a cockchafer on the bottom rod as well. Not really expecting anything off of that one, but it just made sense. Good fish. A good white fish. Another Vindus, I think. 15 grim Vindy. Might have missed one on this rod. Yeah, I did. Grand Vindy. trying to decide, do I want to put a big hook and fish piece on the bottom rod and just yeet it out there by the island there? See if we can't get vermin overnight. Debating that, how I want to handle the overnight hours. Do I want to go for burbot? Perch. Fish. One of those places where it doesn't take much to get a good day. Just a couple of decent whitefish, and we have a good day like last time. So. Nice 319 gram Vindus, and another good Vindus, 212. Again, I'm kind of glad I switched between the two rods, so I hooked them both. I think between the last float episode and this one, there was a patch mainly focused on the new Norwegian sea and saltwater fishing, calculating wear on rigs and things like that. So nothing that's going to directly focus or impact us. I do think there was some performance tuning to being able to sort and search in the shop, which could be nice, but nothing directly impacting us from a float fishing perspective. Another decent 300 gram Vindy. 139 gram Vendus. Gonna be a Vendus day, evidently. Wow, this one immediately got bit. $734 gram whitefish for 4,000 XP. I'm happy. Not a big whitefish, but it'll do. Also 11 fish in 11 minutes. And it was a weekly record. Another U.S. weekly record. Looks like a small whitefish. I was going to say small Vendus, but it's an even smaller whitefish. I need to drag these apart just a little bit since they're the same float. I just realized I left the fan on, not directly blowing on me, but I don't know if the microphone's picked it up the whole time. It doesn't look like it's doing anything different, but if I sound a little bit different, that might be why. I've got a tower fan blowing on me. It looks like my noise gate cuts it out. At least when I'm not talking, I'll turn it off here. After this fish. $400 gram Vendi. Nice fish. And has been turned off. Gonna have to go listen to the first 13 minutes and see, just for curiosity's sake. As we start getting into the warmer days. Supposed to be low 80s today. It's 73 out there right now, so it's not too bad. A little bit warm in the house. Got aluminum siding in my house, is broadside east west, so it's a little bit warm at times. Miss that fish. I was getting the bottom rod cast out, and I might miss this one too. I did. Dang it. weekly record Vendis Telestick 405 gram. Last one, but I'll take it. If you didn't catch what I did there on the bottom rod, I put a 1/0 hook on with a fish piece and just cast it out, trying to get it to the deepest part as I could. Not really moving from this spot, so see if we can't get a burbot overnight. Looks like a decent whitefish, 356 grams. And it was a marker. That's money. You don't know what I mean by marker. A lot of people have different terminologies for it. That green check mark means it's of a certain size and worth significantly more silver. Somewhere between 20 to 60 times more silver, usually. Had fish that are 1 gram off markers a couple times. Couldn't remember if we were close to a milestone fish or not. And might have gotten faked out there. While I was turning on my light. I remember correctly, the last day, time we were here on Monday night, this spot was pretty active at night. Uh-oh, what do we have here? Like a Arctic char. The marker, it is 1.7 kilos, 69.1%. Nice. I will take that. Either whitefish or a Vendis, I can just barely see it nibbling. Oh! Watch the fish even move that time. I swear that one was on. This one's a Vendis. 230 gram. Weekly record Arctic Char on Telestick as well. Again, just a US one. Fish, take it. There you go. That's a white fish. Or Savon. No, it was a Vindus. Wow. 368 gram Vindy. Fishy. 439 gram Vindus. That'll be another weekly record. Another weekly record. Fish. Like that? I Touch Ducks. That's an interesting name. Saw that one swim up. You can probably see that Vindus nibbling. The other one just came up and started nibbling on rod one. Oh, that surprised me. Fishy fishes. good Vendus. 218 gram. A little bit surprised that 439 gram Vendus hasn't shown up as a weekly record yet. Because I think the 500 gram one, or 405 gram one was. Yeah. There it is. Almost as if it heard. Four gram Bindi. Doesn't look like we're going to get a Burbot. Vendus? No, the small whitefish, unfortunately. Although it was worth more XP than a decent Vendi would be. Fish. And 61 gram Bindi. fishy fish. Gram whitefish for 700 XP. Ah, that's a fake fish. Around and lay on the other side. Time for the dog. That's a good whitefish. $1,529, $8,200 XP. And probably another US weekly record. Minutes in, 25 fish, not too bad, especially for only two rods. Gram Bendis, and looks like nice weekly record Corey Whitefish Telestick and normal. $238,000 XP from leveling up. The Fartinator. I think that's going to win name of the day. That one got me to laugh. Never grow up, people. Never grow up. Our jokes will always be funny. be a whitefish. I don't think it is. I think it's a big Vindus, though. It's a pellid. 966 gram pellid. Gram Vindus. This one might not be a marker. Now it's a small pellet. What ever game? I definitely should have been a fish. It's a little bit late. I may have to cut it off a little bit earlier. We'll see. Fishy fish. I'm evidently boring the dog. He just rolled upside down. We're coming up on 42 minutes, and it's already a little bit late. I didn't realize it was as late as it was, so I need to get this episode uploaded and processed and all of that, so cut it off a little bit early. Still got 29 fish. I don't think it's going to be as good as last episode, but should still be over 100 silver. Actually, I'm going to guess 130 silver. A 4.5 silver fish. We'll take a quick look at the cafe as I run by here. Looking at the cafe, not the drink machine. Nothing there. As we didn't get 8 big perch. Didn't really expect to get anything there, honestly. Had to look on the way by. Sometimes there's a vent disorder. 135 silver. 136, basically. I will take it. 32 for the big white fish. Gets us up to just shy of 6,000 silver. On the character, and for weekly records, telescopic US, it just reset weekly again. We still have all the Corey Whitefish trophy era weekly records, and then Vindus's 3 of the 5, including number one there. If I look at normal weekly records, yes. Corey Whitefish. So many new fish. I'm not used to how far I gotta scroll down. I've got 4 of the top 5 US normal Corey Whitefish as well too. Looks like Stink Spinks. That's a great name. Got a nice one on a worm, too. And for Vindus's, probably nothing on there. Yeah, they're all big ones. Either way, decent day overall. So hope you all enjoyed. We'll be back again tomorrow on the Spin Fishing character. And we'll see you then. Bye-bye now.